Hello, everybody. Welcome to Life Through the Lens. And I got to tell you, I am so excited. We have so many awesome things to talk about tonight. And it's all about the G Plus love, baby. First off, we are going to be talking about the G Plus Mentorship Program for Photographers. And as a matter of fact, our esteemed co-host, Mr. Ron Clifford, is joining us tonight as our featured guest, along with the lovely and talented Robin Griggs Wood. Both Ron and Robin just recently completed the first round of the mentorship program as mentors. So I am thinking that they probably have a little bit that they could share with us about that. And I know we have a lot of questions to ask about it. We also have our Life Plus One segment where we get to share with all of you photographers on G Plus that inspire us. And last but not least, dun, 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 thanks to Brian Matiash of On One Software, we have one brand new spanking Perfect Photo Suite 6.1 to give away. So stay tuned, because later in this very episode, we are going to tell you how you can have a crack at winning it. So, my name is Kelly Seeger Kim. I do macro photography. I co-curate Macro Monday here on G Plus with Carrie Murphy and Jennifer Eden. If you want to see any of my work, you can find it on my Google Plus profile page. Next up, we have Ms. Karen Hutton.
Hello. Hello. I'm Karen Hutton. I am home here on Google Plus, but you can also find me online at karenhutton.com and Life is Light Photography. Why two websites? Because I do voiceovers professionally. I'm the voice of Stuck on Earth, the app, and MotionX GPS Drive for the iPhone. So that's the Karen Hutton, and the photography is either here on Google Plus or on my website, and I'm happy to be here.
Woo! Mr. Keith Barrett, the awesome stud that he is streaming this and recording it for us. Hello, Keith.
Hello. Thank you for having me. I'm Keith Barrett from VidcastNetwork.com and all over Google+. You can find me at keithplus.me. I'm a photography enthusiast. I have my own tech show on Wednesdays at 9, and thank you for letting me be here.
Thank you for being here with us. Carrie Murphy, hi!
Hi!
You did that so good!
Hey everybody, I'm Carrie Murphy. I'm a photographer. I also work full-time, have two kids, run. You can find me on Google Plus most often. I also have a website at carriemurphyphotography.com, and I also co-curate Macro Monday with Kelly Seeger Kim and Jennifer Eden, and also co-curate Women Wednesday with a whole host of fabulous ladies. And I am also happy to be here.
And Ms. Robin Griggs Wood. Hello. I don't want to screw it up two times in a row.
I love you, Kelly.
I love you, too.
Thank you, everybody, for letting me come on this with your showtime. Anyway, I'm Robin Griggs Wood. I have a website, robingriggswood.com, but most of my new stuff is on G+. I've basically talked at Google. I love Google. Okay, no more high squeaky voice.
Well, then I'm out. Also, Tamara Prusner. Hello, Tamara.
Hi, all. I'm Tamara Prusner. I am a photographer in Tucson, Arizona. You can find most of my recent stuff here on Google+. I do have a non-updated website, www.throughtamseyes.com, and I also curate Floral Fridays.
Tana Teal. Good evening,
hey.
Tana Teal.
Hi, I'm Tana Teal. I'm a photographer in Eastern Washington. You can find me pretty much here on G+, a little too much probably, but you know, I like it, so I just stay. And I also do have a website, the Tana Teal Photography. It's always constantly being updated, so I come to G+ first to check it out.
Right on. And there's no such thing as too much, baby.
No.
Mr. Ron Clifford, our featured guest of this evening, how are you?
Oh, I'm doing well. I'm really, really, really excited. Probably going to step over my own words tonight. I'm Ron Clifford. I am a Google-aholic. I love the community here. I love all the people in this room especially. And you can find me here on Google Plus or on ronclifford.com. What we're going to be covering tonight, though, is something that's really near and dear to my heart, and that's the G+ Mentorship Program for Photographers. Both Robin and myself here are mentors in the program that Randy J. Braun started a while back now. Do you know how far back that was, Robin, that he started that?
Oh, good heavens. Mine ran for like 3 months, and it took me about a month before I actually got it up and going. So it was before the end of last year.
Yeah, so it was pretty early on when
he was a go-getter, definitely.
Yeah, wow. And so when I heard about it, I actually heard about it through Ronnie Delmonico, and I was really interested in what that looked like to be a mentor, to share what I've learned about photography and creativity and art with people who are just beginning or just learning. I thought that would be a really great experience. And so I inquired about that, and it started a journey that is indescribable. We are actually in our last week. I'm about to put the last post out now. So I know, Robin, you finished yours, and I'm just about to finish mine. So we have one final week left, and everybody, of course, is saying they're never going to let me stop, that I have to keep doing it over and over and over.
They know, mine too. So, they're all my buddies now, though.
Yeah. So the premise of it is the G+ community is a vibrant place where people share their experience with each other. What I found about the mentorship program is that initially I thought I would start out sharing a bit of my knowledge with people and being kind of like a teacher-student relationship. And what shocked me was it became, just like G+, it became a community experience. We're all learning from each other. Even though I may be sharing some technical ideas and some creative ideas, I'm learning about new relationships like every day. And the mentorees and the auditing group that is watching have begun their own relationships and their own friendships as well. So, I'm just super, super pumped about it. With me, I have Gisela Nyquist. She started the program as an auditor. And what an auditor is somebody kind of on the outside looking in. I can only be spread so thin, so I accepted 6 people that I would mentor directly and a group of 21 others that I would allow to observe and encourage and talk about in posts, but I couldn't directly mentor them. I had one mentoree that couldn't maintain the program, and Gisela had been working so incredibly hard at her auditing that she just melted right into that mentoree role, and she became a mentoree. So, Gisela, why don't you tell us a little bit about what brought you to this point, to entering into the mentorship program? What's your background?
It's not a creative background at all. I was born and raised in Hungary, and I was a mathematics and techniques high school teacher.
Wow. Yeah.
So couldn't be further away from photography. about 10 years ago, I had to quit teaching for some reasons, and I was just bored at home, so I decided to teach myself web design. So when I was done with that, then I created a magazine for Hungarian children.
Wow.
So,
holy smokes.
Not creative.
I always liked taking photos. I just didn't really know how to. I used my auto on my camera, and you know, we had about 100,000 pictures to look at, but I never really learned about it. So last fall, my husband offered that I could get a new camera if I never use auto again.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Nice. That is excellent.
Just a little motivation for you.
Yes, absolutely. So I love the idea, and I started reading books. Kobe Brown just had the Denver Photo Walk, so I went there. That's where I heard about Google Plus. So I had been on it, but I had no idea what Google Plus really was. So I started being interactive. I went to Scott Kelby's program, and then suddenly Ron showed up. And I was like, oh my goodness, this is exactly what I need, because being a teacher, I know that I need assignment. I need homework, and that's how I will actually get into it and be better. So it was really helpful after self-teaching myself and doing lots of reading and watching videos that somebody actually told me that by next week I have to have certain pictures done and show them.
And I'm such a hard, hard teacher. I force you guys a lot, right?
Yes, absolutely.
I was going to share with everyone that one of the things that shocked a lot of the mentees and auditors was the fact, and I'm sure Robin, you can relate and you'll share this, is that I encourage them to shoot between 200 and 500 pictures a week. And for someone that doesn't shoot professionally or full time, that seems like a monumental amount of pictures. What I found though is that a lot of the mentorees, a lot of the students found that 200 to 500 pictures really wasn't all that much once you started applying it to a lesson. You have some pictures you want to share with us, don't you?
Sure. Yes. Yesterday I asked Ron if I should have my before Ron and after Ron.
That would be awesome.
So I actually looked at many pictures and I just kept his assignment in mind, how he built his assignment on top of each other. So let me get a pictures ready. Okay, so these are my windflowers in the backyard, and I took this picture about 2 years ago. And so after we talked about composition and all that stuff, this is how I saw that same windflower this spring.
Wow! Yeah. Big difference.
Yeah.
And like this.
Oh, get out! Yeah. I love that. Holy smokes! That's
wow.
Gorgeous.
So definitely, I'm seeing things
differently.
So here is a door from Hungary, and it's a very pretty door, and it's tilted, but it's not tilted for the right reason. So I wanted to show you a door picture that I took just about a month and a half ago.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Fantastic.
Man. This is going to be so fun
tonight.
That's awesome. And get your Kleenex out, people, because this is going to be rocking.
Okay, so I don't take pictures of cars, so I had to really dig, and this is from 2001 in Hungary. But here is a car picture, and then this is what I took a month ago.
I love the angle that you did that one on.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Unbelievable.
I'll just before you talk about the next one, I'm just going to share that one of the first assignments that I had them do is to take a photograph of something until their subject is sick of them. Take someone and it was to encourage them to see things from a new perspective and a new angle and all the students got that so well, and obviously you can see that Gazelle is demonstrating that.
Smokes.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah.
I'm seeing Ron in a whole new light now.
Right? Yeah. I'm like, I need to be on his list.
would you like to see any more?
Yes.
Please.
So this is a rose from my backyard, and it's probably from 2 years ago. And here is one that I took this week.
Wow. Oh, it's amazing.
That's gorgeous.
It really is. Holy smokes.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Wow.
And here is my daughter when she was 4. And she was just painting. And I dug this picture up because just a few weeks ago I had to take a picture with the primary colors and, you know, using all the knowledge I got, and this is what I did.
Oh,
that's so great.
Yeah.
How can you not smile when you
That's
talk?
Awesome.
I know.
I mean, you really learned like how to work angles.
Yeah,
angles are tricky.
Holy smokes.
That's incredible.
And that one's demonstrating not just new perspective and seeing, but that's her assignment for primary colors as well.
Oh, excellent.
Yeah. That is perfect.
It is.
Okay, maybe the last one, last set. So this is a sunset from Hungary from about 2010. And it's an okay picture.
Yeah, it's nice.
I like it.
And yeah, I
so this one I didn't plan. We were just driving and my daughter pointed out the sky. So I just got out of the car, took the picture. But this one was
well planned.
Wow. Yes.
And very well executed.
Definitely.
This was for an assignment and I wanted to find the right spot and put the right rock in the right corner and just wait for the most perfect moment to happen. And this is what happened. And
I'm blown away.
So finally, this was the last week, or 2 weeks ago, I think, we had an assignment about the rule of space and all kinds of things. And this was another sunset picture that kind of encompassed all of that.
Yeah, I love because your eye just travels from the waves to the little dry patch there all the way back down to the seagull. Oh, my.
Yeah.
Dang. It's really, really good. Yay, Gisela and Ron. Holy smokes.
So I could have any one of the students come on and go through just folder after folder just like this.
Well, I would like to, since you mentioned any student, I would like to interject with something that one of them wrote.
Oh, please do.
Tyler Finklia, who is actually a friend of mine and whom I have known for a long time and known of her love of photography, and I remember how excited she was when she began auditing the program, and then I watched
her. And she's in the chat, too.
I know. So, yeah, uh-oh, Tyler, hello. So it was natural that I would read her words, which are multi-handedly, because Ron Clifford has like eight, right? She wrote that. Ron gave me the opportunity to audit his program. There was a lot of trust involved the first 2 weeks in carrying out the assignments and shooting 500 shots a week. 500 seemed like a lot until I realized I was consistently filling up my 4 gigabyte and sometimes my 8 gigabyte cards. Shooting more to get the feeling for through the lens is an important takeaway for me and something I'll continue to practice. The program has also offered me a sense of community, and it's been so valuable to read the feedback that Ron has given other students as well. Building relationships with others in the program has inspired my photography, and Ron went over and above helping me with Photoshop. I know this to be true. This is me talking now because she talked about this, Ron, all the way through. Like, just couldn't thank you enough. In reality, Ron's mentorship has taken all the bits I've learned through science, art, math, physics, and psychology and helped me integrate them into my photography. To me, hold on 1 second. To me, it makes my photos feel alive and my shooting more purposeful and fun. Thank you, Ron, for this amazing 2 months of learning.
Yay!
I don't know how many get through. We're going to have to move on soon. But there's one, one of my students, Kathy Binns, wrote like a David Letterman top 10 for me. And I wanted to share that with everyone before we kind of move on and have you, if anyone has any questions before Gisela has to go. But Kathy Binns writes, and I'll do this hopefully kind of like David Letterman, number 10. He's shown me that shooting 200 pictures in one day can be considered taking it easy. Yeah, number 9, taught me rules. I like rules. And forced me to ignore them. Did I mention I like rules? Number 8, showed me how to hang out. And that's been really, by the way, that's been really a really, really important part of the way this goes, is the fact that we can hang out live together and talk or go over Photoshop or Lightroom. It's a really important part of the mentoring that you couldn't do in other venues unless you were in the same community. But now we're around the world doing this. One of my students is in Kuwait, It's just fantastic.
Wow.
Anyway, number 7, Kathy says, motivated me to make new friends with cameras on my first G+ photo walk. 6, proven that G+ friendships are real friendships with real people. And number 5, inspired me to use old curse words in new creative ways.
I love that one.
That's great. Yeah.
Number 4, forced me to spend so much time out of my comfort zone that I can't remember where it was.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah. And number 3, never patronized me. Number 2, always encouraged me. And number 1, permanently changed how I see things, including myself. Wasn't expecting that. Thank you.
Aww, I just got a little goosebumpy and stuff. Come on. You totally be getting the group right now.
Yeah. Fishes.
Gosh.
Ron is an awesome teacher.
Man.
And I just, if I had to say one sentence about the program, I would say that the more I've learned from him, the worse my old pictures look.
That's excellent. That's a good indicator. Well,
here's looking at the next 100,000.
That's great.
Wow.
Is there any last questions for Gisela before we kind of ask Robin to take the show?
What was the thing? I have one question, Gisela. What was the one thing that surprised you the most?
Everything. Every week, no, really, every week, Ron brought up a topic that I kind of knew, but there was always at least one little thing in there that I didn't. So there was a challenge in there. And then I was like, okay, he can't challenge me anymore. Yes, he did. And yes, he did. And I love that, that even though I had something to build on, I'll just tell you an example. The Fibonacci. Spiral. So I had been using the grid, but I never used the spiral, and that was just so difficult to use when I was taking pictures. Using it in Lightroom was fine. Just taking a picture where I want to put something right there, and I've been practicing it, and it's working now. So
great.
Very clearly,
cool. very
smokes.
Cool.
Well, see this? Yeah. See this face? That's all I can see.
Yeah, that's good.
That's awesome. All. Thank you, Gisela, so much for coming on the show and sharing.
Thank you very much for inviting me.
Absolutely.
Happy shooting.
Yeah.
Hey, yes. Wow. I can't wait to see what else you're working on right now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Holy cow. That's all I can keep saying.
Thank you, guys. Yeah. And you will see me.
Yeah. Yay. I'm going to be stalking you.
Okay.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Now, Robin, you're part of the reason I'm doing this, too, and you're a mentor, and you gave us an update about probably 6 weeks back, I think, by now.
Yeah.
So why don't you give us a little bit more of an update now that you've finished your program, and I hear that you've got one of your mentorees to invite into the chat room as well.
Yes, I actually would love to show pictures from some of my group, maybe while you get Brian invited and get him on here. Just to give everybody a recap, this was mentioned to me by Randy J. Braun, and he kind of prescribes it for about 4 or 5 people, and I had so many people sign up that I kind of ended up taking on about 30. And this kind of narrowed down over time to about 20 overall that I really ended up handling. But I'll tell you, I wouldn't have traded it. I couldn't have let go of any of them. They were all so fantastic, such a great, great group of people. And I kept having them, you know, why are you doing this, Robin? Or I can't believe you're doing this. And it came to me, I mean, I know why I'm doing it, but the way to explain it came to me in this thing that's going around the internet now about the meaning of Ubuntu. I don't know if you guys have seen it. But it's the story of this anthropologist. And he has all these kids, he's kind of testing them, kids in a tribe. And he says, I want you to race to that tree. The first one that grabs the basket of fruit gets to have it all. And when he shouted go, They all grabbed hands, they ran to the tree together, and they all sat on the ground and shared their fruit together. And the anthropologist was stymied by this, and he said, I don't get it. Why, if one of you could have had so much, why did you do that when each of you is just having this little bit? And they basically replied, how can one of us be happy when the rest are sad? And it's really why I do this whole thing. I want everybody to feel the same way I feel when I create something. That feeling inside that's, wow, this is cool. I like it. You know? And too many times I see people make comments, oh, I have no talent. And I'm like, that's bull. You can create this. You just, you know, you need a few ideas and a playground to play in. And that's what my mentorship is basically. It's a playground to play in. Some fun toys. Anyway, if I may, and I want to actually read a couple of the plus. I actually had people write up plus posts. They are just kind of a recap of their week, the things that they got out of it. It helps to solidify their own certainty of what they got out of it, or what they want to change, what they want to grow from, etc. And so maybe I would like to be able to read a couple of these. So what do I need to do? I need to do the share screen share. Sorry about that. And can you see?
Oh, yeah. Good old Fibonacci there. Yeah.
Yeah, well, that was one of the ones that I did. I mean, I used to kind of present the concept to them. So anyway, this is Tawny Henlon. I think she's in our chat room, aren't you, Tawny?
Yes, yeah.
Anyway, this was her, whoops, that old hover zoom, huh? This was her entry,
wow.
Her composition and lines. And one of her plus posts, I'm just going to do little brief inserts of these. Aside from giving me some rules, but not rules, to work with, I appreciate the creativity that Robin shared with all of us. The way she creatively presented the weekly assignments was refreshing. When the time comes for her next mentorship program, I encourage everyone to apply. It is challenging, but I learned so much. And she really did. She's amazing.
Wow, that's beautiful. Really,
this is Alex Lapidus. I don't know that I'll pronounce anybody's names properly.
I love this one.
This is so adorable.
Isn't it cool?
Wow. So I love how you can see his reflection in the fence.
Isn't it great?
It's like he's checking himself out.
Sorry, go ahead.
This is one of the ones for surprise. And I thought this was absolutely incredible, Alex. His little plus post at the end of his mentorship, everyone has their own way of presenting their work here. Some people only post a few brilliant, perfect shots. If I ever create one, I promise I'll post it. But in the meantime, my choice is to continue offering what I can, more or less every day if possible. I believe all my shots are subtly improving thanks to Robin's program, but it's just as important to me to understand what makes a great piece of art. When I started here, I could see that my work wasn't the same level as the real professional photography being offered here by so many people. To close any of that gap, I have to understand it. That's an enormously important gift that Robin has given me. I know, I'm so glad you guys can't see me right now. Now this is Pam Wolf, and I hope it's okay if I say, Pam, that you're a little shy in the program. But this is absolutely stellar. This was her surprise image. And when I first saw it, I'm like, you know, that butterfly is not really much of a surprise. I mean, I could just see it. It's right there. But then look, it's dining with a bee.
Yeah.
And I was like, wow, girl, you nailed it. Totally nailed it. Anyway, this is her plus close. This journey has been more than I could have hoped for. And with the information still available to me, I can now spend time perfecting my new abilities. I truly didn't think I had any artistic ability when I began. This mentorship has pulled out of me what I didn't know was there. For that, and for the wonderful friends I've made, I will be forever grateful. That surprised me, Pam, and I thank you so much for that.
Aww. It's really pretty.
Yes. Okay, I threw them into the deep end the first week. I made them do a selfie because it is the hardest
thing. Nice.
Oh, nice.
This is hot. Yeah,
this is Don Carl. She had never, ever done a selfie before.
What? I know, this, right?
Yeah. So this was based on story. The idea of a story is to include only what tells the story and nothing else. And I think that she did an absolutely perfect job. She blew my mind.
Incredible.
Phenomenal.
Yeah.
I just love this.
Isn't it incredible? Yeah, Don.
Unbelievable.
Wow.
Yeah.
So she loves New Orleans, totally loves New Orleans. And her, she says, after joining G Plus in beta with so many amazing photographers, I was inspired. I wanted to be better, and I wanted others to find joy in what I shoot for New Orleans. Robin allowed me to learn from a point of view I'd never considered before, looking at photography as a way of getting across the bit of joy I have when taking a shot. Yeah. I am now more confident, more attuned, more determined to share my love of New Orleans. Thank you, Robin. Oh, sorry.
It's making me all chills, too.
You will never know what this program has done for my heart, my mind, and my soul. I have a new purpose in life, one I haven't felt in more than 5 years. I bow to you, dear lady. Thanks for the wake-up call.
Aww.
And she woke up good, didn't she?
Yeah.
Holy
yes.
Cow.
Holy cow.
And this is from Sarah King.
Yeah.
And
wow.
Yeah, it's pretty dynamite. Sarah was also, I'm sorry I'm saying this out loud, that I don't feel that Sarah had a lot of self-confidence in the beginning, even though she kind of wowed me from the start. She writes, when the post for the mentorship program first went out on G+, I thought about entering, and I almost talked myself out of submitting my name for the program. As a beginner, I wasn't sure if I'd be able for it, but the pre-mentorship nerves soon evaporated thanks to Robin and all the other participants. My confidence and belief in myself as a person, a photographer, and an artist has grown beyond my wildest dreams. A few weeks ago, I was approached and asked by a musician to attend his gig as his personal photographer. I was a tad nervous, but I jumped at the chance. Before the mentorship, I would never have agreed to do something like that. When I got to the gig that night, I put everything I learned from the program to use. Now, a number of those shots are being published as his album cover and promotional posters. And now,
wow, that's excellent.
That is so great.
Oh, my God.
Awesome.
I wholeheartedly recommend signing up for the next available mentorship program. The knowledge and friendship has surpassed my wildest expectations.
Yeah.
That is so great.
I have to go. This is Kyla Palin. This was the week of light, and they were encouraged to just play without rules. To just play. And Kyla, I have it. She says, we were to set aside our inhibitions and just play, do all the things with light that we always wanted to try. I finally got out of my own way enough to play. What got me going? My kids. I used them as subjects. I used their toys, and I delighted in watching my older daughter, who just started to discover photography, play and teach herself that a flash can throw different colored light by placing things in front of it. She just put her hand in front of her flash and got so excited about the result. She started looking for other things to place in front of the flash for different colors. I was in awe watching Robin's process in action. I think this is what calls us to creative art in the first place. It's fun. I signed up for this program about progressing artistic vision through photography. It sounded a whole lot more fun and useful to me than another program teaching me what, dial controls, aperture, etc. I'd always been told I have an eye for photography, but it bugged me that I didn't know why. Why I like certain shots or why other shots didn't work, even if it seemed they should work. It's hard to put into words what I got out of the program, but I feel more confident. Confident in composing, in post-processing, and in viewing my own work and others. Robin promised us that we would be able to never need another person to critique our images, that we will be able to use our new knowledge to do that for ourselves. If any of you are ever lucky enough to get into one of these mentorships, do so and stick with it. You'll be glad you did. Anyway, Kyla, go look at her work, you guys. She's fabulous. And this, is our Elizabeth. Hi.
This kills.
So great.
That's awesome.
I adore that.
I have seen her doing this in person, and it is so cool to watch her work with these.
Wow. And I chose
my
this image of Elizabeth because it was representative of what this program was like for us. She started on this. I mean, we had so much fun. She started on this whole thing how during the light week she wanted to go out and light paint a cow, you know, long exposure with a flashlight and go over the cow. And she couldn't find one. She couldn't find the right conditions, et cetera. She couldn't find one close enough to a fence. So she went out and did this gorgeous piece of work.
Excellent.
And the brief words of hers that I want to share is, by far the lesson that will stick with me the most is to play. And I don't know if I have any time, but I actually wanted to just show you just a couple more without talking too much, and then I'll show you Brian's. This is Gary Monroe.
Gary, that's
cute. Good for Gary. This is a prize-winning shot to me.
Definitely.
First place. This is, next one, come on, is Doug Welch. And this was, in the very first week, his story. The concept of story is to do only, to grab those things only that only tell the story. I'm not talking very well now. And these were absolutely perfect. You could tell this was a traveling dog, but he was well cared for. He's alert. I mean, it was such an excellent story. LaDonna. LaDonna
cried.
Very
cool.
Oh, awesome.
I was doing tips, man.
And that's just exceptional. I had to show you. And here's Brian. Brian, I'm still going to let you say your
name. Oh, Brian.
and can we segue to Brian now?
Yeah.
Brian, that kills.
Are we inviting him?
We need to invite him.
Yeah.
I thought, hey, you were supposed to be doing that, man.
We weren't sure. We were holding off for a second.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Oh, man. That's
awesome.
I love that. I can't even say how much I love that shot.
This is Ilva Bujo, and I'm saying her name wrong.
Oh, those hearts.
Her composition.
That's awesome, too.
Yeah, it's incredible. Just tell me when Brian's on and all. This is Yuri Nyberg. This was for story. Incredible. Absolutely incredible. He called it Ignored.
Wow.
And I love how everything is black and white except for the person that's actually
ignored, isn't that
which
awesome?
Is awesome, yeah.
Yeah, it's really fantastic storytelling. Emma Mitchell, this was for composition. Just blew me away.
Excellent.
It's an absolutely perfect composition. Do we have Brian yet?
Those chickens were modeling perfectly, too.
Jennifer Eden!
Yay, Jennifer! Gazzaroni T, I gotta wait for this to go away. And, wow.
Whoa!
That's beautiful.
It got even better! I was loving it even when I didn't see it.
That's cool.
Alan Lanny. It's a wonderful story image about a bridge where people put locks on to confirm their love.
Yeah. Right about that.
Brian has joined us, Robin. Brian.
Oh, yay, okay.
You'll have to let us know how to say your last name so we don't really mess it up completely.
Yeah, because I would so.
Are you muted, Brian? We don't hear you yet.
Oh, I think you're muted.
Hey, Brian.
Oh, no.
Okay. Technical difficulty. They're always ever present.
Griluski. Can I do it? Griluski, darn it.
I kept wanting to say Griluski, but it's Griluski. Griluski. Did I say it right, Brian?
Griluski. Oh, dang it. bummer, Brian, you're so muted.
Yeah.
That's just a little bit of a
hold on. You know, just take the headphones off and try
plugging in a different USB slot.
Yeah, that could work, too. While he's trying to get that working, I was just going to read another little piece here.
Yay!
From Shannon Brearley, who's been really, really engaged in the program. Such an encouraging mentoree. She's always commenting on other people's work, and she's really applying as much as she can to the program. And she just has a little blurb to say. She says, "This program has been absolutely amazing. I've learned so much about myself as a photographer, about different ways of approaching photography, and most importantly, I have made even more amazingly valuable connections. I've learned so much from all the people involved, and it's great to have their support and encouragement." And that's to say nothing of you, Yoda, but Jedi Master. Your help kind is small pushes to go outside my comfort zone. Small pushes. She's saying that gently. And friendship have made this one of the most treasured learning experiences. She says, I've decided that you must keep us forever. Yeah. Thanks, Shannon.
Yeah. That's what I want to share. Brian might have to pop out and come back in.
No. One thing you can try is to pop in, out, and back in again, Brian.
Right. It's just to exit and
we'll leave
it open
Aww.
For you.
We'll
leave a light on for you. Yeah. Just give it a shot. Exit and try to pop back in, unless he's trying to tell us he can't stay. But
no, he's not.
Oh, wait. Hey, can you hear me now?
Yay!
Now you can tell us how to pronounce your
name. That's an entrance.
Yeah.
It's very easy to say, just as long as you're not looking at the spelling of it. It's Jaleski.
Oh. Jaleski.
Jaleski, yes.
Yeah, I would have never gotten that.
No. Nobody would ever get that.
Jaleski. Hello, Brian Jaleski.
Hi, Brian.
Hello. I'm glad Thanks I could finally here. Make it.
We are, too.
Sorry about that. Anyway, I'm glad we got you here, Brian. I'm not sure, Robin, did you have something set up that you wanted him to share specifically?
Oh, absolutely not. I'm totally going to put him on the spot. I told him, he needed to do something entertaining. He was really upset because he'd given up his juggling lessons a while back, so.
Robin, you do that so well. No, I've seen you do that before.
I am a no mercy mentor. Let me tell
you. Oh, she is.
Performance.
Crack that whip.
Well, let me tell you, I first of all just want to echo a lot of the things that have been said already. We were all amazed at the amount that Robin gave to us. Both in terms of the weekly assignments, there was so much knowledge, and also in the feedback and encouragement, it was really great.
And the amount of tears that you shed after reading my tomes.
Yeah, it was a lot of work, you know. It took a lot to keep up with it all.
Well, I was basically trying to cram about 10 years worth of art lessons into 3 months. So.
Yeah, and
it was challenging. Fantastic. To put you both together. Brian, what was your background, your photography background before starting with the mentorship program?
Well, I had had a digital camera for a long time, since like 97 or something, I have a blog that's been running for 10 years now.
Wow.
It's adventureswithandrea.com, and it's just a travel blog. And so I had been, you know, taking pictures and trying to kind of tell a story with the pictures for a long time, but I didn't have any sort of formal art training.
Yeah.
And, you know, I knew my camera well, but I needed to know a lot more. I actually, like a week or two before the mentorship was offered, there was a post where I had talked with Kelly and Carrie, and I was asking them, you know, what's your advice on getting better? You know, which, you know, was completely open-ended. But, you know, they had some good advice. But then along came this mentorship, which was absolutely perfect for me. She had described it as, you know, this is not a class for how to learn how to use a camera, which was, you know, just perfect. It was about how to create art and becoming a better artist. And so it was a perfect perfect match for me.
Yeah, and so you feel then that doing the mentorship program has opened up your creativity? It has done that for you?
Yes, definitely. One of the main things I've gained from the mentorship is just an expansion, similar to what Giselle was saying. There's I had knowledge in lots of different areas. Like, you know, I knew a little bit about composition and color and things like that. But Robin gave us, like she was saying, a tome about each topic, and then the opportunity to go and really work on those gave us all a lot of great experience, you know, trying out new things and pushing our boundaries. And that new experience, you know, gave us a lot of confidence, too, I think.
Yes.
Holy cow. I didn't even know that you were in the mentorship program, but I've just noticed, like, for Macro Monday, your shots are blowing me away.
Yeah.
Holy cow.
Yeah.
Really. Yeah. It's just incredible.
So there's a question for you, Brian, from the chat. BJ Denning asks, how long has the program been completed, and have you maintained the technique without the structure and encouragement?
I definitely, well, the first half was how long has it been completed? It finished a week or two ago, week and a half. And so, you know, it's just recently finished, but I don't see how I could not include all the things that I've learned. Even as it went along, it lasted 12 weeks, and, you know, as it went along, I was always referring back to things we had learned in previous weeks, and I can recognize in my own work things that I know now, and when I'm shooting, I compose differently now and stuff, you know, it's all becomes ingrained because we're working with it while we go.
Yeah, I'm gonna bring something up. Robin and I talked about this in a hangout the other night, and I didn't mention it specifically in my my mentorship blog. I run a blog for the mentorees and the auditors so that they can keep going back instead of trying to find lost posts in G+. And what I want to do is update it on the next round, and I will be doing another round. I'm not sure if Robin will be, but I'm definitely going to do this again when this one finishes. I'm going to take a short break, probably a very short break, and think about what I might want to change and what I want to keep. But what I did notice, you were saying you're shooting now and you don't really think about it. You're shooting differently now, and you're not thinking about it as much. And what I wanted to share was we had read some things about people saying how at first they thought maybe 200 or 500 or more pictures was going to be a lot and how that ended up not being a lot. And what I was going to share was for people interested in doing the mentorship program, it's really important to have your camera in front of your face, to take as many pictures as you can in as many angles as you can, because what you're doing is building a new neural pathways. And what you said is you're creating new pathways of creativity. And what happens is, at a certain point, you're no longer thinking about it. At a certain point, you're just taking really nice pictures, and you look back and you say, wow, I'm doing this now. Where before you were wondering, how do I go from taking nice pictures to taking really good pictures? And the process is in keeping the camera in front of your face, and not just blindly shooting, but having the guidance of someone like Robin behind you week after week, coaching you through it.
And I'll say it was key, and if somebody else is going to do this mentorship, it was key to take the lesson and do as much as possible right away with working with shots in that style. And trying to, you know, use all the different styles and especially ones that you hadn't used before. You know, there were new compositional elements or styles that I didn't realize that I never make shots with a lot of negative space, you know.
Yeah.
And so I needed to try some of that more. Or using kind of lines to draw the eye to the subject and stuff. I never really did that much, so that was another thing that I tried to do extra.
What about replicating the work of another artist? What did you think of that one, Brian?
Well, that was a week where I kind of fell down.
Get you over the head with it?
Yeah. So I wanted to do one in kind of the style of Alan Shapiro, whose work I love. And he has these great bird pictures with a lot of texture around them. You know those.
So. Yeah, like 73 layers in Photoshop kind of textures. Yeah.
I think Tyler can relate too.
You that? Sure.
Right.
So, you know, I actually, maybe the reason I thought of him as an artist to replicate was I had a nice picture of a pelican that I wanted to do, and I kind of forgot some of the lessons we had learned in the earliest weeks, and you know, it was just a reminder that I really need to go over them again, and I definitely plan to. I had added some textures and colors around the outside, kind of the style that he did, and I put too much kind of red in it, and I was drawing the attention away from the
subject. I was pretty cool, Brian.
I
thought it was amazing that you chose that to do. I thought it was a huge task to take on, and you handled it pretty well.
Thanks.
Pretty big task. He's like, so what mountain would you like to climb as your first mountain? Mount Everest.
We're getting close to, we're going to be moving into a plus one segment, but I wanted to know if you had an image or two that you wanted to share that were especially meaningful from doing the mentorship program.
Especially meaningful.
Oh, show us your selfie, Brian. It rocks.
Okay. You know what? While Brian is looking, can I share something that an auditor said about Mr. Ron Clifford? It's Chuck Palmer.
Oh,
and Chuck Palmer said, thanks again, Ron Clifford, for these assignments. I must say, I have learned to truly see new dimensions in all images and everyday true life scenes as the weeks fly by. I have heard that people who have cataract surgery are truly surprised at the colors they can see after the medical procedure. For those of us who have little or no artistic training, the last few weeks have removed a few shades. I can now see things I never saw before through the viewfinder. I will probably never make a living in photography, but I'm enjoying the hobby more every day as my vision improves.
Oh, wow. Love that.
Holy cow. And what kills me is how so many of these people are writers, too, right?
Yeah.
Exactly.
Perfect, you know?
I know, they're all eloquent.
And stuff.
Ron, let's see Brian's images and then tell everybody when he's done. Tell everyone, I know you said it's coming up soon, but exactly how, because I've had them asking on Facebook, on my stream, now in the chat, where they can sign up, how they could become eligible, when the next one is, just because now more and more people want to be involved. So where they can go to be up to date with all the information. But let's see Brian's images first.
Holy cow, Brian.
If you'll indulge me, I'll go through these really fast. There was just a few images that I'll show. And this, I just wanted to illustrate how I tried to use a bunch of different compositional styles on that week that we were doing it. There was a flowering bush in front of our house, and I just sat down for a half an hour and I challenged myself to try to do as many different compositional styles as I could. Wow. So these were all from kind of that one flowering bush.
Wow.
And this was
that's beautiful, Brian.
Kind of using a shape, the V shape.
That's a Macro Monday shot.
Yeah, it is. And yeah. I love the little brown like twig thing at the bottom. It's
I like how you're pointing at that for us, Kelly.
I know. You know, it's right there. Can't you
right
see
there.
That
one?
That's
sorry,
awesome.
Again, no, I made it go away. This one was to use a foreground to kind of invite the viewer into the picture, and there you can see the whole bush there. This was using negative space.
Yeah, that's nice. And the colors are nice,
element
too, the
there.
Tones.
Mm-hmm. And this was using kind of the golden mean on the placement of where the flower was.
Totally nailed it.
Yeah.
And, that one blew me away, bro.
That's right. Saying, come to me.
I will tickle your fancy.
Okay. Ryan, holy cow.
Okay.
I love this selfie. How much did I love this selfie, Brian? I loved it so much that I harassed him for endless amounts of time to make it his profile picture for a while.
We were stalking for a while.
But this is especially special because it was only my second selfie I had ever done. My first one was also in the mentorship program. And so, you know, I learned a ton by doing that, you know, about how difficult it was, first of all, but also in this week, we were playing with light, and so trying to work out getting the light right on both sides of me, you know, so one side would look like it was lit up by the lightsaber, and the other side would have just a little bit of detail to it. When I'm not even in the picture, you know, I had to be, you know, shooting it and then running back and forth because I didn't have a remote. So, you know, the experience we got was invaluable.
That's awesome.
Freaking awesome.
Ron, you posted in the chat where people can just be up to date. You mentioned a blog, and I know there's a G+ page, and I just know lots of people.
What I'll do is I'll just say that I had posted the G+ Mentorship Program for Photographers is a page on Google+ where you can go and see when new mentors are announced, and that you can sign up to get hopefully chosen. What I want to mention before I go into it is it's really important, like Brian mentioned, is to be able to commit some time to this. You only get out of it what you put into it. It's an old cliche, but it's never more true than it is in this program. I'm sure Robin can attest to that, that the people that invest time are reaping huge rewards.
It's my biggest criteria, actually, is that I see the person, because I check out everyone who applies, and that I see that they're interacting.
Yeah.
That they're posting regularly and that they're interacting, because that is a key element to the mentorship, that these people support themselves because they're all going through the hell together.
Right.
The hell of 200 shots a week. You
know, one of the challenges we have is getting enough mentors for the amount of response we've been getting, and I'm sure we're not going to get any less now that we've put it on the show. I have a shout out to anyone who's an experienced photographer that feels they'd like to share their skill, to get in touch with either Randy J. Braun through the website I shared in the chat, the G+ Mentorship Program.
Why don't you say it out loud also, because some people will see this and not see it.
Yeah, that's G+ Mentorship Program for Photographers. Or you could probably message me or Robin would be able to.
Absolutely. And I will steer you in the right direction or give you the info you need. Yeah.
And so that's Ron Clifford and Robin Griggs Wood, singular, on Google+.
That's right.
That you could find out more about either being a mentor or joining the program.
Yeah. I am going to be running mine, I'm pretty certain, within a couple of weeks of finishing. So I'm finishing in a week. In a couple of weeks from that, I'll be announcing another program.
Awesome. So just watch your stream.
And I'm gonna probably do a, because mine it turns out that it works best as a 12-week program instead of an 8-week, because it's really a lot to take in. So I'm gonna start it as a summer program. So check my stream out for announcement on that. Probably like beginning of June or mid June. And there'll be data as to when it's starting.
Yeah. I do know that Daryl Van Gaal is doing, this is really cool, he's doing astrophotography, night photography, the moon, the stars, a mentorship program that's going to last over a much longer period because of the way you have to wait for conditions to be right. So that's really cool.
Exciting.
That's
cool.
Yeah, that's really cool.
Has he started that yet, Ron?
Yeah, he has started it.
Yeah, okay.
And he's taken on quite a few as well, but I think because of the nature of the length of his class, he can handle more. He's Superman too, I guess.
So,
but yeah,
I just encourage
you to stay in touch with that G+ Mentorship Program for Photographers page, who does the announcing of the new mentors that are coming up.
That's awesome. Robin and Ron rock. Thank you.
Holy cow. I think I said holy cow like 50 times.
I love how you venue to do this in.
This is fantastic. So thank you so much. We've got a few more minutes. We're going to do our wonderful that we love so much, our Life Plus One segment. Tamara is going to share an inspiring artist. Then we will announce the contest for how to win that on-one software suite.
Very exciting.
Woo-hoo! And we'll also announce our next guest. But first, Tamara, who inspired you this week?
You know what? I had such a hard time choosing. There are actually two people, and I'm still sitting here staring at both of these pages going, okay, I only have time for one, but I'm thinking, you know what? I'll just run through them real quick and I'll do both.
Yeah.
Because I can't pick. Yay! I cannot pick. Okay, so here, let me share in the chat so you guys can share all.
Okay, because I got my circling finger ready. So
let me tell you.
Poised on the mouse.
I know you have one of them at least, Kelly, but I don't think you have Lucy. Lucy is freaking awesome. Lucy Dubulkova, let me pull up her stuff real quick while I'm trying to pull up
her
stuff.
Whoa. Yeah.
She is absolutely, oh my gosh, to die for amazing photography. Yay. So her stuff. And I couldn't even pick a folder because, she separates them into different countries. So, like this one from Wales.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Holy smokes! Like, holy cow!
I really love her colors.
Exactly. Holy cow!
Yeah.
I'm stealing your word.
I totally understand.
let me find another one. Like, they're just, I'm just sitting here through these, and I'm not a big landscape photographer. I try, but it's really not my strong point. And so these are so amazing to me because, I mean, I look at these and I'm just like, I want to do this. I want to learn how to do this so badly.
Yeah, that's outrageous.
It's just, she's amazing. And it's Lucy Dubulkova.
I posted it in the chat.
Good.
I appreciate that. I think some of her favorite ones of mine are actually down in the Czech Republic, which aren't technically like landscape photography, she's amazing. She's absolutely amazing. And then the other one, his name is, I'm going to butcher his last name. I know I am. It's Joni Mella? Is that how you say it? I don't know how to say his last name. But I found him, back when he had, I swear, only like 100 people had him circled. And I was like, whoa! I was completely blown away, and I kept sharing his stuff.
Wow.
And people need to go through and circle him because, like this,
kills.
He's amazing. Yeah,
he is. It's like he's got his own little world in his backyard. It's like this alien planet that he has. I swear it is. I mean, where else could you find something like this?
Wow,
it's gotta be on another planet.
Yeah, that's excellent. Yeah, I do have them circled.
Yeah.
I thought you guys did. Yeah, like.
Oh, so good.
Get to this fly.
Oh, my gosh.
Absolutely amazing.
So good.
I think he started doing some new stuff, too, because this is all stuff that you can see on his website. And then I think back in this other album, where is it at? 2012. Yes, I think this is his brand new stuff that he's working on, and it is killer.
It's also so clean.
Yeah.
That's gorgeous.
Oh my gosh. Wow.
I am completely blown away by the snowflake.
Everything
pictures.
I can not to say holy cow right now.
Or just
you
about.
Don't want to, just do it.
Holy light cow.
Holy cow. Dropped. Speechless.
That's awesome.
I can't get anything out of my mouth.
Of course, you know, the reason why he's on my list is because he does such great macro work, and I always find that fascinating. But he does some great stuff that isn't macro, like this.
Yeah.
And of course, you know, I'm in Arizona. I don't ever get to see this kind of stuff.
No.
Between this and the snow, I'm definitely a follower.
I'm pretty sure my pictures of snow would not make you fall in love with.
Pictures of yellow snow, probably.
Well, those are fantastic. Thank you so much, Tamara. I don't know how you always find those.
We find them.
Find your the new artists.
Right? You gotta dig.
You know what? It's not just me that finds them. It's somebody in my stream will reshare it. This is why it pays to have 3,500 people circled.
Right. Right.
Somebody will share it, and I will be happen to sit at the right spot at the right time, and I'm like, oh, inspirational circle.
Yep.
That's where you're going. I'll decide for later. Yeah.
Mine.
That's awesome. So our next show is in 2 weeks.
Yes.
Hannah Teal knows who's going to be.
I do. Our next guest is Laura Bulk, and she, if you don't know who she is the curator of Portrait Tuesday. So very excited, and she's been kind of doing some stuff lately. Her life kind of took off and opened up for her, so I'm really excited to kind of find out what she's been up to lately other than what we've seen her post.
That's
so.
Definitely. Yeah, she is crazy talented.
Yes,
holy cow!
Yeah.
Holy cow!
I don't know, it's holy light cow.
Yeah.
Holy cow, yeah.
So, drum roll for our final thing here tonight.
Big giveaway.
The On One Perfect Photo Suite 6.1 giveaway. We're going to try and do this one a little bit different each time to offer you the most opportunity to win this thing. So tonight, here's how it's going to work. We have a question. The question is, and don't answer it now because you got time to think about this. It's going to all happen tomorrow. The question is, if you could choose anyone to be your photo mentor, since we've been talking about mentors tonight, if you could choose anyone, doesn't matter, anyone, to be yours, who would it be and why? Write your answer in my stream. That's Karen Hutton on Google+. And write your answers in my stream. You can start tonight if you want to, but this will go on all day tomorrow. The cutoff is 7 p.m. Pacific time, 10 p.m. Eastern, after which Brian Matias with On One Software will help us decide who is the lucky winner, and we'll announce it in my stream as well. So once again, if you could choose anyone to be your mentor, who would it be and why?
Oh, yeah.
Boom.
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 The correct answer is Karen Hutton.
No, that is not the correct answer. I'm sorry, you just lost.
It would either be Brian or Nicole.
That would depend on what I want to
That's who you would pick.
Yeah, that would be the appropriate one. So, anybody else got anything? Anything good?
Ooh. The new show tonight. This is my long night.
Yeah.
Our very own Tamara Prusner is going to be on the panel on the next show coming up after ours. We're going to do a shortened version of our after show afterglow once we're done here. Because tonight Tamara is going to be on Photo Talk Plus.
Yes. With Mickey Ostreicher. Oh, can I tell you how excited I am to be on the show with him? He is the attorney for NPPA.
Is this the show that got postponed from earlier?
Yes, because of all those horrible hangout problems.
Yeah. That are now resolved. Thank you, Google Plus.
Yay!
So you're going to be on Photo Talk Plus next. We're going to wrap up with this hangout because we have to end it to then start a new one, which will be our after show where we all let it all hang out and talk about whatever.
Yep.
So we're going to end this. And then
don't get your hopes up, people.
Yeah, actually, you probably can.
We watch Tamara knit.
And then, so I'll end this now, but then hang around and we'll be back on Vidcast Network as well as in my stream in just a couple of minutes. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Thank you all. Bye.